Today on the CEO TV show with Robert Reese, we'll explore business transformation from three aspects: taking a company out of bankruptcy, how philanthropy actually drives strategy, and transforming healthcare in America.
Peter, talk about what it was like when you took over as CEO of Marvel.
Well, Robert, I've often said that going through the bankruptcy process, which Marvel had just emerged from, particularly for a public company in the United States, is like going through chemotherapy. And when you emerge from bankruptcy and you emerge from chemotherapy, your organization is actually still very weak. And our biggest challenge was to build up the organization. We actually, at that time, had $250 million in debt. And the interest rate on that was 12%, so we had to generate at least $30 million in cash to cover the interest, which we couldn't do emerging from bankruptcy.
So what did you do?
First, we adopted a licensing model. We wanted to conserve all of our cash, conserve all of our capital. The second thing that we did is we decided to make motion pictures the major means by which we were going to promote our comeback and rejuvenate our characters. The movies were very important to us because with hit movies, it generated and drove a lot of our other businesses. Would help the comic book business, would help the video game business, would help the toy business, would help back to school, depending on the character.
And what was the real result of that?
Well, after 2 years, we had successfully turned around the company.
I know you have a certain philosophy about the importance of philanthropy.
It used to be about writing checks. It's not about that anymore. It now goes to the core of the company's operations. You know, the market has spoken. The market, the public, cares what kind of citizen you are, whether you're well motivated, whether your actions make the world a better place or a worse place. And you don't pay attention at your peril. And so I think good citizenship, philanthropy, corporate social responsibility, all those words that we use to describe this, you know, what I think is, you know, doing the right thing, have to be at the core of your corporate strategy now. They're not something you do with the last, you know, $5 million that's left over. It is at the center of what you do, and when you do it right, it actually drives your business. You know, you look at something like IBM doing Smarter Planet. It's, yes, we sell hardware and software and services and all those things, but we never lose sight of the fact that our responsibility is to make the planet a smarter place.
So you're saying that philanthropy is really systemic to strategy?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I don't know how you can not consider what your role in society is when you're a company in this day and age.
George, as we look at healthcare, it's 17.6% of the GDP in America, and yet we don't have as strong clinical outcomes as many nations. What's the problem and what's the solution?
Well, part of the problem is that the business model of healthcare in this country is badly flawed. We pay for pieces of care. We don't pay for packages of care. We don't pay for outcomes of care. We pay for care by the piece. And so we get unconnected, splintered, unfocused, uncoordinated, unlinked care delivery far too often. 80% of the cost of care comes from patients who have more than one health condition. And we have no linkages and no ability for doctors in this country to link, to work as teams to take care of those patients. So we have twice as many heart attacks as we should have. We have twice as many kidney failures. We have twice as many asthma attacks. We actually have inferior care, even though we spend more money than anyone in the world.
Is there anything at the systemic core that we can improve?
10% of the patients are 80% of the cost. So if you focus on the 10% of the patients who are 80% of the cost, and then you identify what each of those patients needs as a care plan, and then you deliver on the care plan, you can cut the number of heart attacks literally in half. You can have a huge impact. And if you just let the person have the heart attack and then rush in and try to do remedial work, get them through the hospital stay, and then ignore them again, until they have their next heart attack. That's a really stupid, inefficient, ineffective, and incredibly expensive way to deliver care. So we get the 17.6% of the GDP spent on care when we deal with it totally after the fact as crisis care. And then re-engineering care inside hospitals to make sure that hospitals are safer is also incredibly important. When you look at hospital care right now, the number one cause of death in hospitals is infections. More people die of infections than die of stroke, heart disease, cancer. I mean, the number one cause of death is literally infections. And if you deal with the infections right, you can prevent many of the infections, and you can also treat them much more effectively and much more quickly, and you can save lives. And we also need to look at repricing care, because we spend twice as much on a CT scan, we spend twice as much on a prescription drug. Compared to the rest of the world, prices here are double. And if we paid world prices, we could afford American healthcare easily.